Simon & Schuster Audio presents The 7 Habits of Highly Effective College Students, Succeeding in College and in Life, by Sean Covey, read by Jesse Boggs. This audio program presents a series of ideas, principles, and practices designed to help you improve critical skills you'll need for college, as well as for life in general. In addition to the main narrative, you'll also hear special features that offer specific insights under the heading, Did You Know? This sound is your cue for these features, which are read by students Megan Fleischman and Cooper Bennett. Now, the 7 Habits of Highly Effective College Students.
Chapter 1. Welcome to the 7 Habits. Congratulations, you've made it to college. That's great. Now your next goal is to graduate. After all, you didn't come all this way just to get in. You came to finish, right? For you, finishing might mean 2 years and an associate's degree, 4 years and a bachelor's degree, or 6 years and a master's degree. Who knows, maybe people will be calling you doctor in a few years. Regardless of how long it takes, graduation will be a great day. But the path won't be easy. College can feel a lot like a marathon. I remember coming home after my first day at college feeling completely overwhelmed. The campus was huge, I didn't know anyone, and I wasn't sure I could succeed there. Starting college can be a shock, no matter how old you are, whether you're 18 or 28 or 80. Suddenly, life is much more complicated, especially if you have a job and a family and money issues. So what I'm here to do is to help you succeed in college, and not only in college, but also in life. Let me tell you about my friend David. He started at a state college not long ago. He doesn't want to just put on a cap and gown and march across a stage at some point. He wants to make the most out of school. He wants to learn from great thinkers, to meet people from all over, to expand his mind, and to be well prepared for the job. But he also wants to do it effectively. He doesn't want to fall behind, take longer than needed, and waste time and money. He wants to do it right. My guess is that you feel the same way. You've worked hard to get here. Now you want to do it right. So, how are you going to succeed in college? For starters, I've learned that successful college students have 3 things in common. First, a compelling reason for going to college. Second, solid academic skills. And third, effective life skills. These things make up what I call the college success formula. First, you need a compelling reason, a burning why. If you have a compelling why, you'll be more likely to finish college. Take the example of Isaac, who grew up in a neighborhood where few students made it through high school. Rarely did anyone think of college. Every day, he felt pressure to go the route of gangs and crime, but somehow he caught a vision. "I wanted something different for my life," he said. Isaac saw college as his path to a better life. No one in his family had ever done it, and when he shared his dream with his high school counselor, he was told he wouldn't make it if he didn't have a sports scholarship or join the military. When neither of those options panned out, Isaac refused to be stopped. At age 18, he left to fend for himself, got a job, and immediately began setting aside a little cash for tuition. After 4 years and much personal discipline, he enrolled in college. Today, Isaac is as committed as ever to graduating. His compelling why to attain a better life keeps him working hard and sacrificing. I think these experiences will make his why even more compelling over time. It's just as important to know how to succeed in college as to know why. You need 2 sets of skills, academic skills and life skills. Academic skills include writing, reading, test-taking, studying, note-taking, critical thinking, researching, and presenting. Of course, you also have to know how to navigate the campus, use the library, get help from your professors, and use online resources. Some students already come with solid academic skills, while others need to develop them. Most colleges know this, so they set up academic support centers, mostly at no cost to you, for tutoring, mentoring, and testing. There are also lots of resources on the internet. Many colleges have college success courses you can take that will help you build study skills and life skills. You may even be using this audiobook in one of these courses. If you haven't developed good study skills, it's not too late to start. Jerry had lousy study habits in high school. After two kids and a divorce, she decided to go back to school so she could qualify for a better job. That was when her study habits came back to haunt her. Reading in bed put her to sleep, and trying to study on the train to work was pointless. Then there was procrastination, a lifelong hobby for Jerry. Plus, the two kids were her darling little distractions. A few changes were in order. Jerry moved out of her bed into what she called her study home, a quiet corner where she could be alone for 2 hours a day after work. She used those hours for heavy reading and saved her train time for light reviews of what she had read. "When the kids are at daycare and I have the place to myself," she said, "I can study until my brain falls out." As with Jerry, your study skills can make all the difference, and it's your responsibility to develop them. No one can do it for you. Finally, you need effective life skills for managing time, setting goals, building friendships, caring for your health, working in teams, and so on. These are just as important as academic skills. You probably know students who are bright intellectually, but struggle to get along with other people or manage their time and money. They might be smart, but they have a tough time making friends or holding on to a job. In fact, a critical reason for gaining life skills is that employers look for new hires who have them. They like to know you did well in your classes, but they also want to know if you're disciplined and good with people. While most employers are willing to train you for your job, they don't want to have to train you in life skills.
Did you know? Life skills make you more employable. EdXL, a United Kingdom-based education firm, recently asked more than 2,000 employers from 22 countries what they looked for when recruiting. They responded with pleas for more life skills, such as problem solving, positive thinking, creativity and innovation, trust, leadership and management, multitasking, initiative and responsibility, teamwork, empathy, communication skills, professional manners, cultural sensitivity. Considering these life skills, how employable are you right now? What can you do to make yourself more employable?
So, how do you improve your life skills? It's all about your habits. You might have habits that work against you, like procrastination or impulsiveness. Why did you eat all that pizza anyway? You gain good life skills by changing your habits, especially if you have darker habits like addictions. The purpose of this audiobook is to help you form new habits, the habits of effective, successful students, habits that will help you lead a successful, effective life. The audiobook is based on The 7 Habits of Highly Effective People, a set of life skills originally identified by my father, Dr. Stephen R. Covey. As a university professor, he spent decades studying the habits of the most successful people and organizations. He reviewed literally hundreds of books and mounds of research, drawing on sources from all over the world and from both classic and modern literature. He started sharing the 7 habits with his students at the university. His classes grew so popular that they were held in the basketball arena. In 1989, the book, The 7 Habits of Highly Effective People, first came out. More than 25 million copies, in 40 different languages later, we are now bringing the 7 habits to you. So what are the 7 habits of highly effective college students? The habits build on each other. When you were born, you were dependent on your parents or others for your survival. Gradually, you move toward independence. So, habit one is be proactive. That means taking responsibility for your own life. Habit two is begin with the end in mind, which is deciding what your life is all about, what your mission in life is, and what your most cherished goals are. Habit three, put first things first, is about making sure that the most important things in your life get priority. The more you live by these first three habits, the more independent you will become. We call it winning the private victory over the self. While it's good to be independent, there is a higher state to strive for. This is called interdependence.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.